Elser to do. Till the bad werewolves arrived on the scene in the 1300s. And since those days that we had spent chasing glory, all we have been engulfed in is a battle for survival. The werewolves have proven to be fearsome opponents, in a battle most would say we have already lost. The past is gone, the dreams simply fading echoes of a past that no longer exists. The only thing that matters is survival. When you turn a vampire, the werewolves can use the blood of that vampire that you turned, to track you. So you only want to turn vampires who have their wits about them and won't allow themselves to be captured by the werewolves and then have their blood used by them to track you. There are many children of the night who have gone to ground, war communities and even vampire communities, and who, like me, are determined to wait it out, until someone else or something not yet apparent, finds the threat without us risking life and limb. Until a way is found to return to the Enchanted Forest. Until that day, I am keeping my head low and playing defense. I would advise the two of you to do the same. Although I know you want two young women as beautiful and lovely as the two of you. The world is your oyster until the trap set by the werewolves closes down around you. And then nothing can save you. Yet I understand your feelings. That, a life without love, a night without blood, quotes the young love to spout, means that you are not living, you are simply existing. Which seems to them a curse. And that is not a life worth living. Or so you tell yourself. And at your age I would not have stood for that either. But now at my age, and with the threat from the werewolves omnipresent and real, merely existing doesn't sound all that bad. And all of that. A life without love. A night without blood, give me liberty or give me death. Puffery, give me a break. It all add up to the same thing, bunk. It's all bunk that you tell yourself. You convince yourself because you want to party. And I know all about that. Believe me. That is all I did for centuries until the plague and then the arrival of the bad werewolves ended all of that. And my friends, the ones who could not leave that life behind. Or change their lifestyles in any way. Determined to live their lives as they always had, filling their days with pleasure and their nights with blood. And like all clever fools, each one was caught in a trap set by the werewolves and torn to pieces. Especially in the early days. Back then I was Mary Dooku's Glynn. Wait, said Mia, something is bugging me. And I've got to ask. Someone turned you when you were so old. Immortal does not mean ageless, my dear, said Mary Kama. We age, just extremely slowly, what? Mia and Ava said in unison. Yes, I am sorry to burst your bubble. We age until eventually our situation is such that we choose one morning to greet the new day and to witness the dawn one last and then we are gone. Many within the vampire community believe that when we greet the dawn, or give up the ghost, whatever the current phraseology is, that after a moment of intense suffering and agony, we awaken back home in the Enchanted Forest. Home. While others like myself are not so sure. Many werewolves still worship us like gods, as they are taught, but the ones who have abandoned their faith and turned on us, th.